mainline gantries. The first one will be located just north of Beltway 8, and that would cover the portion from Clear Creek to Beltway 8. So if you travel on that piece of roadway, expect to pay a toll just south of Alameda Genoa. The next segment reaches from Beltway 8 to 610. The toll gantry for that tolling segment is located just north of 610. So if you travel on this piece of roadway between Beltway 8 and 610 and you're through traffic, you will expect to pay a toll just after 610. And then the third mainline toll gantry is located on the north end of the project. So if you travel through the northern portion of the project from 610 to US 59, you will travel through the third toll gantry. So from Pearland all the way to US 59, expect to pay toll at three locations. We also have toll gantries at the direct connectors linking the project to Beltway 8. So each of these direct connectors has its own toll gantry with its own defined tolling segment. So if you travel, for instance, from Pearland and you want to go onto Beltway 8, you will only use the direct connector and you will pay a single toll to access Sam Houston Tollway. If, for instance, you travel from Pearland all the way up to 610, you will again go through the gantry south of Alameda Genoa, and then you will pay for the segment between Sam Houston and 610, and then you will also pay for the use of the direct connector linking 288 to 610. So again, each of those direct connectors will have its own toll gantry. So in total, we have 11 gantries set up on the system, 4 at Beltway 8, 4 at 610, and then 3 mainline gantries for through traffic from Pearland all the way to US 59. This project will have variable pricing, so you can expect to see higher rates in the morning peak and in the afternoon peak, lower rates during the day, and of course much lower rates during the evenings and after hours. This is really pay as you go. You pay for the segments that you use.